In this video, we'll discuss what output gaps are and demonstrate them on two diagrams. Output gaps occur when an economy's real GDP is greater than or less than its potential output. We can visualize this on two diagrams, specifically the trade cycle and the aggregate demand and aggregate supply diagram. This diagram represents an economy in both short-run and long-run equilibrium at output YFE and price level PL star. There's no output gap associated with this equilibrium level. Any movement of short-run equilibrium away from this position will result in an output gap. So what are positive and negative output gaps exactly? Let's start with a positive output gap. Positive output gaps occur when real GDP is greater than potential GDP in an economy. This could be due to pushing resource use to the maximum, including labor, working overtime, and excessive use of capital. Area X represents a positive output gap in a trade cycle diagram. On the aggregate demand, aggregate supply diagram, it is demonstrated like this. Suppose this economy is in short-run equilibrium at Y1. This is beyond the potential of the economy at YFE. As a result, there is a positive output gap from YFE to Y1. If the previous position was short-run and long-run equilibrium, then this could have been the result of an increase in consumption, investment, government spending, or net exports. On to the negative output gap. Negative output gaps occur when real GDP is less than potential GDP in an economy. This could be due to underutilized resources, possibly as a result of unemployment. Area Y represents a negative output gap on this trade cycle diagram. Now suppose this economy is in short-run equilibrium at Y2. This is below the potential of the economy at YFE. As a result, there is a negative output gap from YFE to Y2. If the initial position was both short-run and long-run equilibrium, then this change could be the result of a decrease in consumption, investment, government spending, or net exports. By now, you should have a better understanding of output gaps and be able to use two diagrams to draw them. If you found any of this difficult, share a comment or question below and let's try and solve your problem together. That's us done for now, and I will see you in the next one.